The following program is a production of HEW Entertainment, heard on the official website of HEW Entertainment. It's that time once again for HEW Entertainment Radio.
And that's all I got to say about that.
Hosted by Jonathan Clark.
The Beat! The Man!
You gotta be the man!
Whoa!
Be sure to join us in the live chat room during the show.
Hulkamania is running wild like it's never ran before.
Call us on one of our request lines. If you live in the United States, call us at 1-641-985-7800, box number 372928. If you're from Canada and would like to call us from 1-647-724-4194, box number 372928. Long-distance charges may apply in some areas.
I've been the World Heavyweight Champion 10 times.
Or you can always drop us a line at MySpace, myspace.com/HEW Entertainment.
And you will rest in peace.
Emailing us works for you too. Email us HEWWrestling@hotmail.com.
I am a wrestling god.
J-B-L.
And now, without any further ado, here is your host of HEW Entertainment Radio, on the official website of HEW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark.
The champ is here!
HEW Entertainment Radio is inviting you to comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
Comment on our video blogs, join the conversation, and like us.
So what are you waiting for? Log on and listen now.
Die.
What's going on, fans of HGW Entertainment, listening to our video blogs on YouTube.com, following the conversation on our Twitter page at HGW Entertainment, Jonathan Clark 1, and who have joined the conversation happening on our Facebook at facebook.com/HGW Entertainment. I, once again, am Jonathan Clark here with you for another video blog. A lot of stuff going on, particularly in the world of professional wrestling, but first off, here at the top of the show, I want to let you know that we are inviting you to tell us what you think of the crucial things that are happening in professional wrestling. This is the word that could be affiliated with everything that's going on. You can let us know what you feel about it at facebook.com/HGW Entertainment. You can follow the conversation on Twitter at HGW Entertainment Jonathan Clark 1, and you can subscribe to the YouTube channel at youtube.com/JonathanClark22, now offering constant news, video streaming, and everything you need to keep in that very important loop. Stay within the loop of professional wrestling news. A lot of stuff going on. We are inviting you to tell us what you think of it all on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Also here at the top of the show, I want to throw out over the air that over the next couple of days, we are going to be doing an informational radio show to let you know what's going on with HGW Entertainment. We got a lot of stuff we're going to be talking about over the next couple of weeks. Everything from the release of Men in Black 3, the first Men in Black in about over a decade. We're going to be talking about the new soundtrack to Victorious 2.0, I believe it's called. We're also going to be talking about the release of a new video game for iCarly on Nintendo DS. We're going to be talking about a lot of crucial things happening in the world of professional wrestling. We're going to be getting ready for No Way Out, coming up in just a couple of weeks, the first No Way Out in about 4.5 years. We're going to be talking about all that, so you're going to have to be listening for the informational radio show to drop on YouTube, Twitter, and Facebook, streaming on all social networks over the next couple of days. And we invite you, if you have any suggestions for some topics that you would like to discuss on HGW Entertainment and hear video blogs and informational shows done on, you can tell us at hwwrestling@hotmail.com, or you can tell us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. So listen for information on that coming over the next couple of weeks. So this week on HGW Entertainment Variety Radio, I decided to talk about how wrestlers seem to be not being pushed as effectively as they should be. Randy Orton and Kane are two victims of this, and it seems like people are falling within that category. Every week you're turning on the television and finding out that other wrestlers, both male and female, are falling within that same category. Three wrestlers, of course, in the male and female category that have fallen victim to this. Kelly, demoted to superstars for some unexplainable reason. Randy Orton, and here recently, Kane. Now, if you've been paying attention to my written column, I want to refer you to In This Corner with Jonathan Clark, which is the weekly written column for this website, which has archives available of it. All you got to do is click on Column in the navigational bar on the top of our website, and you get all the archives for our column. And in some of the recent columns that I've done for In This Corner with Jonathan Clark, I've talked about how wrestlers seem to be not being pushed correctly. I'm very thankful, though, that Christian is one guy who is finally being pushed correctly and finally having something substantial done with his career. Now, I do give WWE credit for allowing him to remain on television when he had a very serious injury. It seems like injuries continue to follow Christian everywhere he goes in his career. Now, this major injury he's just come back off of sidelined him for about 6 to 8 months, and he was on television periodically, doing promos, making appearances, promoting different things for WWE outside of the business. And it's nice to know now that Christian, following his return, is getting something done with his career, and it's in the way of an Intercontinental Championship run. I'm very thankful for this, because Christian is the first sign of light and hope for WWE superstars who aren't being pushed correctly. Some of the victims, if you've been keeping up with my column, have been Randy Orton and Kane and Kelly. And Christian was on his way to being one of those victims, because Christian is easily a guy who can be in a program over the World Heavyweight Championship more than he is, or the WWE Championship more than he is. In 2005, before he left for TNA, it seemed like WWE were trying to push him as a top contender for the World Heavyweight or WWE Championship around draft time in 2005. That would have been around June or July of 2005. WWE couldn't get it done then, and he leaves to go to TNA because TNA offers him a better contract and the dollar value of his contract.